Yellowstone Supervolcano is an active volcano beneath the Yellowstone National Park, a sprawling area straddling Wyoming, Idaho, and Montana in the United States. Given its eruption pattern, it could be ready to blow at any time. What would this mean for America, Canada, and the rest of the world? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what if the Yellowstone volcano erupted? Before we get into this video, I just want to remind you guys that you can become a questioner today by subscribing. You can click on that big old notification bell and be among the first to know when a big question gets a big answer. The Yellowstone volcano last erupted 640,000 years ago. The eruption before that took place 1.3 million years ago, and the one before that, 2.1 million years ago. For those of you out there with some quick mathematics skills, you'll spot a rough pattern here. Honey is due at spew. But these things don't happen spontaneously. Scientists are constantly monitoring volcanic activity in and around the calderas. They have a technologically advanced network of sensors and monitors that are monitoring for signs of activity. They'll know weeks, if not months, in advance. So what if the worst was confirmed and scientists realized the volcano was going to experience a super eruption? Of course, there would be the 1,000 degree flowing lava that would scorch anything and everything in its path, but that really wouldn't be the main issue. What would be the catastrophe causer would be the hot ash thrown high into the air. The ash could fall over a 500 mile, so 800 kilometer radius, from the epicenter of the eruption. This means Salt Lake City, Cheyenne, Boise, and Denver would be covered in over 1 meter of ash. Los Angeles, San Francisco, Portland, Seattle, Albuquerque, Calgary, Winnipeg, Chicago, Kansas City, and St. Louis would see 30 centimeters of ash, and even places as far away as Toronto, New York, Washington, D.C., and Austin in Texas could experience up to 3 centimeters of ash covering. Of course, the jet stream could carry ash as far away as Europe. To put this in perspective, just a millimeter of ash is enough to cause airport closures, seriously damage property, and cause breathing problems, as well as shut down transportation links such as airports. This means that the fallout would include the total destruction of Midwest agriculture, and rivers and streams would be clogged by ashy mulch. This would diminish the water supply of the United States and some areas of Canada. If this is just the damage millimeters of ash can do, what about the people living close to the volcano? Well, unfortunately, it's curtains for them. The closer ash falls near the eruption zone, the less time the air will have to cool the particles of searingly hot volcanic ash. People who had not evacuated within a 100 kilometer radius of the volcano would die, and the buildings would practically melt. The death wouldn't just be focused in on the immediate radius either. A lot of people with asthma and other respiratory problems would be at serious risk. It isn't just ash that would be the problem either. In the long term, a super eruption from Yellowstone would throw gases like sulfur dioxide in the air. Lots of these particles in the air can absorb the sun's light and reflect it back out into space. This means we wouldn't get as much light or heat on Earth as we're used to. This would cool the climate for anything up to 10 years and would have the ability to affect rainfall patterns and generate more freezing weather. This could devastate crops around the world and not just the United States. This could absolutely lead to famine. Many millions of people, if not billions of people, would starve. The long-term effects can be just as catastrophic. It is estimated that the damage caused by a full-scale eruption of Yellowstone could cost the United States $3 trillion, with 20% of the country's total economy destroyed or severely disrupted. While at the moment we are unable to stop an eruption, NASA does have an idea for a $3.5 billion plan that could greatly reduce the risk of eruption. We'll just have to wait and see how funding for that one goes. So that is one scary question answered for you. What questions would you like answered next on Life's Biggest Questions? For now, guys, thank you for tuning in. I'm Rebecca Felgate. Stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning. Hey guys, thank you for watching to the end. Here are two excellent playlists that we think you guys will enjoy. Bye!